3D printers are great, but they're noisy. Really noisy. So noisy, in fact, that I have had to buy myself a pair of noise-canceling headphones. Oh, that's better. But they're not a definite solution. Especially because I have to sleep. Why do I print at night? If you're asking that question, it means you don't have a 3D printer yet. But Marty, I hear you ask, why don't you buy them TMC Silent Step Stick Super Fancy Extra Pure Drivers? Never mind, I'll find someone like you. I wish nothing but the best for you. How many did you say I would need? If only my printer's drivers weren't integrated. What about smoothing diodes? Well, yeah, I'm too lazy to change those connectors so that they fit. What about motor damp- Way ahead of you, pal! So, how do we solve this? Well, of course, with 3D printing, because nothing makes more sense than a machine whose main and only purpose is to repair itself. As any good 3D printing project, it has to start with Fusion 360. And of course, the first printed prototype which will for sure work. The main idea is to suspend the 3D printer from cables. However, since hanging it on the ceiling has proven to be a challenge, I have designed these feet, which will have more or less the same effect. These two pieces will be held together with a nylon cable. Hopefully, this will provide an acceptable level of dampening. I just have to pass the fishing line through each and every hole. Well, that was a whole lot of holes. I don't know if someone can clarify this to me, but for some reason, tying fishing line seems impossible. The knots keep coming loose. So I used a bit of UV curable resin. Okay, so the first one is finished. Luckily, I have a bit of experience with computers, and anyone who has used one before might know this little trick as well. Oops, that was one too much. Okay, nylon is somewhat stretchy, but not stretchy enough. If only I had bought an entire spool of flexible filament just to try it and then never actually used it for anything. Actually... Okay, so it's needle and the thread again. Thank goodness this is a normal filament and you can actually tie it. Now that is way better than nylon. Nylon. Flexible filament you had laying around and was useful for nothing else but this small project. Okay, now we need to replace the old nylon ones with flexible filament. Wait, what? What? But I don't even have Windows. But it worked. In order to test the performance, I wrote a script in Python that generates G-code to test the frequency response of any 3D printer. And then run the test without feet, with a nylon feet, and with a flexible filament feet. And these are the results. As you can see, the nylon does dampen the major resonant peaks, but it does not seem to be effective outside the resonant frequencies. On the other hand, the flexible filament is better in the entirety of the spectrum, reducing the sound levels at least by a factor of 3. Alright, bye!